Good afternoon. Thank you for coming in today for your appointment for your eyebrows and for your semi-permanent tattooing. It's not really like a tattoo. A tattoo goes all the way into the epidermis, and we're not going to go that far in. The cosmetic makeup that we're going to be doing is semi-permanent, so it'll last a good solid 6 months before you might start to notice it fading a little bit. But one good side is that with the semi-permanent is if you don't like it, give it a couple of more months and it'll eventually just fade away to almost nothing. And if it is something that you're content with, you can always go a little bit deeper in making it permanent longer term. Okay. So I see that you do have your eyebrows grown out a little bit. Oh, that's beautiful. That's great. Actually, that allows us to work with the framing of your eyebrows. So where they start, where they arch, and then the tails. So if there's any particular characteristic you want to emphasize, such as the arch, you want to have a little bit of a peak. Yeah, that fuzziness kind of gives us a little bit where we can shape around. Okay. Well, if it's okay with you, let's get started with the consultation, then I'll give you a hand mirror, and you can make sure that these layouts, or if there is something that you want to change, we'll do a couple of samples, and then you can tell me how you would like to proceed from there, okay? Wonderful. I'm gonna put your hair back. And let's see. Tuck it in there. Okay. I'm going to take a little bit of cleanser. I'm just going to clean the skin a little bit. Do you have any kind of allergies that you're aware of? No, okay. Not with any kind of tattoo or any kind of metals. There's no nickel or anything like this, no. Okay. Now, tell me a little bit about what your desired outcome is with your eyebrows. Do you want them to have a natural arch? Do you want them to follow your brow bone? Okay. So you like the peak, but you don't want them to be too thin. Sure. I'm going to take a couple of little dye samples, and I'm going to just brush them or swatch them and see what best looks against your skin tone. So if you have like a brassy, shiny finish, or if you have more of a yellow tint. Also, if your skin is gonna have any kind of reaction, I'll be able to see it with this. Okay, so that's gonna be a little bit more of a bronze. And now we're going to go with a little bit more of a chestnut. And these are not the actual dyes I'm going to use. No, these are just the sample swatches. I think that that's a pretty good match right there. You want to go ahead and look in the mirror and see what you think of the color differences? I think that the chestnut color is a little bit more accurate in contrast with your undertone on your skin. And it matches your natural hair color a little bit more accurately. Typically when we do a cosmetic alteration like this, we want to go with something that's a little more earthy. And that'll serve as the base, and then and when your natural hairs come in, you're not going to have like this deep contrast between them. Okay. Just my opinion. I'm going to take a little bit of lubricant on a cotton swab, and then we're going to start with a little bit of shaping with a razor. And that way, we're not going to actually pluck. We don't want to take away the resiliency of your hair's ability to grow back. But this will give us a little more structure. Bit of a shaving palm. What I'm aiming for, just to start, is I'm cleaning up this little end here so that we can sharpen the tail. Do you have any desire about whether or not you want the tail to come down? Do you want it to flare up? Do you want it to actually come up more than where the hair normally falls? Okay, so we're gonna try to perk it a little bit. What that leaves is I'm going to stretch the skin upwards, and I'm going to get that underside real quick. A little bit at a time here. Okay. Do you mind taking a look in the mirror and seeing what you think? Okay. Just clean it up a little bit more, okay. Now that leaves the arch pretty clear. And now you do have a little bit of spottiness, like right there. Yeah, you know. Okay. Well, that's one of the really good benefits to this, is we're going to fill it in nicely. This is just going to be a very blended in, nice darkened area, so then you won't be able to tell where the hair is thinner. Okay. Alright. So, if we go with the natural brow line where your ridge is here, you're gonna have a nice thick straight line, and it's gonna curve nicely right around to the edges here. So, a nice straight line, and then curve down. I'm going to just, on your right side, I'm going to shave the underside, and you tell me if you like the thickness of it, okay? Do you want to take a look and see? A little bit thinner or no? Okay. Well, then we'll go ahead and we'll move on to the top. Now, do you want your eyebrows to be nice and fluffy? It seems to be a recent trend to have very full, fluffy, fantastic eyebrows, or do you like them to appear nice and straight and symmetrical? Do you want one to be higher than the other? We're going to try to keep them as symmetrical as possible. I'm going to clean up the top, and I'm going to leave the point here in the center. Okay. And then just glue it up here on the very tail. What do you think? I'm going back to that chestnut color. I'm going to use that same pigment here, and I'm going to just draw where I'm going to be placing the permanent or semi-permanent ink, okay? See towards the end that I have to fill it in. And again, this is more of a preliminary treatment, so if you don't like it, then it'll eventually fade. But if you do like it, we can always make it more permanent. Another thing that we can do is, if you're not so much into the bushy up, we can make mock hairs like they're coming down, so it kind of pinches that very nicely. Like this. No? Okay. Don't worry about my feelings, it's not my eyebrows. So we continue to fill in up here though, and we make that any adjustments that you'd like to consider. You can take your time and think about it. It's okay. I'm in no rush. Okay. Well, since I know what the game plan is, I'm going to wipe that off. And then we're going to put our gloves on, get it nice and clean, and then we will begin the procedure. tester by washing down the area with rubbing alcohol. Do you mind if I get really close and touch your face? Breathe for a little bit. I'm gonna take a numbing agent and put that on there. Again, I'm going to be using a standard beauty bar, and if you've never used one of these, they're quite nifty. This is going to really help the ingredients to sink into the skin much faster. And it feels good, but you'll feel a little buzzing. And then it'll go numb. Sink in there. Okay, and then the other side. I found, even though this is not necessarily beneficial in the functional sense, it doesn't make the ink go in any smoother, it doesn't make the skin any more elastic, anything like that. It definitely makes the treatment a little bit more. It just helps the material sink in maybe a little bit quicker, so the numbing agent goes in. So that's good. How does that feel? Pretty numb? Antiseptic, it's not going to cause any kind of harm by being there, but I'm just gonna get the majority of it off. Okay. And now one last time, I want to take a look in the mirror and look at yourself head on, fully symmetrical. And when you use the razor to shave down the certain areas, so if there's any other adjustments you'd like to make. Okay, you think you're going to be content with that? Good. No, just want to make sure. Alright. Alrighty, let me switch it out. And now this has a And now this has a cup on it so that the needle can only penetrate so deep. It's just a matter of directing it in the right place. So you're going to feel a little bit of a buzzing. Hopefully with a numbing agent you won't feel any pain, but if you do, let me know. We can stop, we can wait, we can put more on. Okay. You ready? You can close your eyes, whatever is comfortable. Let me know if that changes, okay? You want to take a look? Yeah, the skin around it's going to be a little bit puffy, but it'll go down very quickly. Still have those areas that we can fill in a little bit more. You ready? Okay. You're doing great. Hi. gonna bring it up. Go ahead and take a look in the mirror and let me know what you think. Now you're gonna have a little bit of puffiness and a little bit of redness for the next couple of hours. The redness will dissipate, but the areas might have a little bit of scabbing. I don't recommend removing the scab. We're gonna pull the ink out that way. But I'll give you a topical ointment that you can put on that will be a nice moisturizing ointment, but also help the skin to heal without discoloring the ink. Do you want those to be a little bit thicker? Awesome. Okay. Let's just go a little bit further then, okay? You're holding up really well. So you want that on both sides? And take a look. Awesome. Alright. Well, let's get you finished up. We'll put some ointment on there to protect it, to keep the skin moist. And that way, it can heal up nicely. Now, I would highly recommend, if you're going to be going out in the sunlight for any even short amount of time, wearing sunscreen, or better yet, a hat, and just avoiding the sun exposure altogether. I'll get you some of this ointment before you go home. Gonna have a little bit of a cooling agent, so it might feel a little bit tingly. Tingly, tingly. That might be welcome, though. Let me know if there's any kind of questions or concerns. It'll take probably 4 to 5 days for those to heal up, so you might feel that they have a little bit of extra texture and tenderness, and that's very, very normal. Just let it run its course. Don't pull any of the scabs off, just like you wouldn't with a tattoo. Have you ever had a tattoo? Okay. Well, very similar to a tattoo. This will be a little bit quicker of a healing process, though, because it's not in quite as deep. Nonetheless. Okay. Well, you know where I am. If you have any kind of questions, keep it clean. Keep it moist. Okay. Well, then I'll see you in a couple of days. If you have any concerns, don't hesitate to come in. And if you wish to have it refreshed, any modifications, we'll see you when we see you. Alrighty, take care.